As promised in the previous video, we are going to look at the tips and tricks of fertilizer application, the quantity and the method of fertilizer application.
Okay, when we come to second application, which is the ammonia and the urea too, okay. It follows the same method. It shouldn't be done early in the morning. And also, if you are lucky and you get a urea, then instead of using one full hand of urea for 5 maize, you can use it for 6 maize.
Okay.
Because the nitrogen is very high.
In the urea.
In the ammonia.
I want to come back to the same question I asked you. You said, in case it rains, that means you might lose all the nutrients.
Yeah.
Should I still wait till the second application, or I can reapply it maybe a week after or some days after? Because if I have to wait for the second application, that's the 8th week, right?
Yeah, it depends on the strength of the farmer. Because if you apply almost 50 bars of NPK and it rains, and you are going to apply 50 bars in the next day, it's not going to be easy. Another way of fertilizer application, when you talk about the organic fertilizers, we have some foliar and the liquid fertilizers.
Okay.
For that one, you mix it with water and spray. For that one, at times, it depends on the company. Some 100 to 150 ml per one NASA spray, that spray machine. 100 to 150 ml.
Okay.
Some two.
Per acre.
No, per machine.
Okay.
Some two will be 200 and 250 ml per machine.
Okay, so
that machine is 15 liters. It's 15 and 16 liters, but I think the 15 liters are more. So you measure 150 to 200 mils for some companies, to 100 to 150 mils. Then you put it into the machine. Then you top the machine with water. When it's reached the 15 liters, then you start spray on either the maize or the vegetables.
Okay, so for how many acres for that machine?
Oh, for that machine, for that liquid fertilizer, maybe 1 liter can spray one acre. But every liter can spray about 5 of that machine.
Okay.
Yeah. So that is how the liquid fertilizer or the foliar fertilizer is being applied.
And that one, when do we apply it?
For that one, you can apply it in the morning.
In the morning?
In the morning. Mm-hmm. 2 weeks following germination. You see, some people ask that they were using organic fertilizer alone without using NPK.
Oh, okay.
And that's why I'm saying that 2 weeks following germination.
Okay, so...
But if you choose NPK, you can wait. When there is armyworm, then you add that liquid fertilizer. Then you kill the armyworms, and at the same time, it also fertilizes the soil for you.
Okay, so Odroya said, please do a video on how to apply the urea or ammonia first. I am farming on a 1/2 acre of land using the knowledge from this video. Congratulations for choosing to go into maize farming and using the education you had from this video. So he said how to apply the ammonia and then the urea.
You can use that one for top dressing.
Oh.
And that one is the second application. After you apply your NPK 2 weeks following germination, then 6 to 8 weeks, when the maize is about to start a tassel, that is where the second fertilizer application is done. So where you are going to use either urea or ammonia.
Oh,
you see,
okay.
Let's know that you cannot mix the ammonia with the urea.
Really?
Yes, you can use other ammonia or urea for the second application. But we are saying that because of the cost of a urea, maybe you are not getting urea. Urea is 46%. You can replace it by ammonia, which is 21%. And for that one, it's a second application.
Okay.
And the second application too is the same top dressing. So you put it 5 centimeters from the plant or in between plants, and also you measure full of your arms for 6 or 5 plants, depending on the fertility of your land.
Okay.
And also depending on the plant population on the land, how many maize did you put in the hole? That is the factors that I've already explained. So I think our brother will get it.
I think we have another question. The person was asking about the quantity of NPK for an acre.
Quantity of NPK for an acre, every acre needs 2 bags, the 50 kilos 2 bags of NPK for the start.
Okay.
And the second application, which is ammonia or urea, 1 bag.
1 bag.
So in all, you need 3 bags of fertilizer for 1 acre.
Okay.
2 bags of NPK for the first application, 2 weeks following germination, and 1 bag of urea or ammonia with the second application when the maize is about to tassel.
Oh, that's fine. We have another question from Ikena. Okay, said, I am presently doing my land preparation for maize, and I'm tilling the land with hoe because I don't have access to plow. The land size is 2 acres. Can I plant without tilling? What is the implication?
My brother, you can plant without tilling, because some part of Ghana, plowing and tilling is not practiced because of the nature of the land. My good farmers at Western Region, because the land is a forest area, you cannot use tractor.
Okay.
But they still plant.
Okay, so he can do that.
So he can do that. But only that, as I said in one of the videos, you should maintain the distance.
Hmm.
And also the culture practices, the weed control, everything must be perfect. And the fertilizer must be applied at the right time. If all these practices have been done, he's going to get his yield. Because the northern part of Ghana, we are able to plow because it's a plowing land. That is why we are plowing. But if the land is not a plowing land, it doesn't mean that you cannot also do maize farming.
Okay.
Yeah.
We have Roman Kojo.
Yeah.
Let me say, if you want to use the inorganic fertilizer, how many bags per an acre?
Inorganic fertilizer is the MPKs. It's 2 bags per acre.
Oh, 2 bags. That's the inorganic.
That's the, yeah, 2 bags.
Anon Alexander said, please ask him if I can apply any fertilizer to my granite farm.
This is a very important question.
Yes.
You see, granite farms, even northern regions, they don't normally use fertilizers for granite.
Okay.
It's good to use manure. Mm. If you want to use fertilizer, unless you get a fertilizer with a high phosphorus or maybe potassium, but nitrogen fertilizers should not be encouraged as far as granite production is concerned.
Oh, okay.
Mm.
I want to ask a question related to Okeke's question.
Yeah.
Ikena, yes. You know, since he said he's not going to plow, he doesn't have access to plow or machine for plowing.
Yeah.
Then he decided to go for the organic fertilizer.
Yeah.
And he broadcast it. How can he be able to mix that with the soil?
If you cannot till the land or you cannot plow the land, applying organic manure, I don't think it's good for you to broadcast.
Mm.
Because when you broadcast, you waste some of the manure.
Okay.
So the best way is that you have to do a top dressing.
Mm.
Although normally organic fertilizers, when you use top dressing, it's not all that, but you can use top dressing by putting the organic fertilizer maybe 5 centimeters from the maize. If possible, then cover it. It will do the same work.
Oh, okay. Okay. So now let's look at the next question from, is it Grazia Integrated Farms Ghana?
Yeah.
Said, can you please do a video on how farmers can make or process organic fertilizer at their farms? Example, chicken, cattle, grass cutter, goats, and pig manures.
Organic manure is very simple to process.
Okay.
You see, this one, the organic liquid fertilizer is not easy. It's not easy. You pass a lot of proof, but the manure is not difficult.
Mm.
You see, you have your poultry dust.
Mm.
Keep it in a very hygienic place and keep it in a way where there is no water. When you are processing, it doesn't need water.
Okay.
So you just your warehouse, you get your small warehouse or small room. When you get the manual, then you put it there. When you get manual, you put it there, small manual. So when you get you get about 15-20 bars, then you start your small processing. This time you just separate the unwanted, the feathers and this thing which is not good, then you just remove it. And if you like to, you sieve it. When it's for the cow and other this thing, for that one too, you just put it in the you heap it in the one place and you get them. At times some people have a stick or something like hoe that they used to hit on it so that it becomes soft or granular.
Okay.
So that they can apply.
Oh, okay.
So if it is for goat and the rabbit, you see, for the goat and the rabbit, you see their drops is like a manual. It's just run. So that one, how to organize it is not difficult. Mm. So when you dry it and it's done.
So for that one, you have to dry it.
Then you have to dry it.
Mm.
Then if you want to get more, you can, the one that you dry, you can just put it in the sack.
Mm.
In the other 25 kilo sack or 50 kilo sacks.
Okay.
Then you keep it. Maybe you do it in the dry season and you want to use it in the major season when it is raining.
Mm-hmm.
That is why he's talking about process method.
Mm-hmm.
For that one, you have to dry it small. You do some small selection, then you bag it.
Oh, okay.
So when the time is due, then you go and broadcast.
Oh, okay.
So that is how the simple method you can use to process that organic manure.
Okay, so that means when you dry, it's going to preserve it. It's not.
Yes.
A big shout out to all those who have been asking questions constantly on this channel. We have Constant Boydo, we have Martin Alipo, we also have Odroyao, Elvis, Ike Now KK, Grazia Integrated Farms Ghana. Then we have Anno Alexander, and Roman Kojo. I think that's it. So I mean, you are doing very well for following up with this videos. So we've talked about fertilizer application for some time now. Where do we get some of these fertilizers?
For fertilizers in Ghana, we have a lot of companies that import fertilizers.
Okay.
But because I'm not advertising for any company, that is why I always mention the active ingredient 23 times 5 20 10 10. But I have an Indian company which always support our farms, and their fertilizers are very good.
Okay.
That is at times how I do recommend. That's ETG.
Mm-hmm.
ETG input.
Okay.
And their fertilizer is very good.
Okay.
And I'm the my main distributor.
Oh, okay.
In Greater Accra.
So you distribute their products?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Not Farcom or ETG alone. I distribute all the company's fertilizers, but that is what I use for my farm.
Okay.
That's the ETG Agro.
Okay.
Or ETG input.
Okay.
They have 23-10-5, they have 20-10-10, they have ammonia, urea, and all sort of agri inputs plus
okay.
seed.
Okay.
Even the lake and the seed code that I'm selling is for the ETG.
It's from the ETG.
ETG Ghana. So if anyone or any of our, even I think last week when I was going to Atibubu, one of our subscribers from Jamasi bought some maize seed, and I sent it to Jamasi.
Wow.
Yeah, Jamasi to him. And 1-2 at Ijura. Yes, 1-2 at Nkranza.
Oh.
So our subscribers are doing very well.
Oh, thank you so much for
And one of
that.
Our subscribers from Muhammad is also from the farm is at Afram Place. He bought the LG 36 for
wow.
70 kilos for 70 acres.
Wow.
So we also do delivery.
So if you want some of these agri input, the maize, I mean, if you want the right seed, you want the maize, and you also want the fertilizers, you can get in touch with Mr. Boachi. He'll be able to sort you out, make sure you get all the necessary input so that you can be able to have a fruitful yield.
Let me highlight on this point. Anytime we are buying fertilizer at a high cost, we need to also think about the way we are going to apply so that we will not lose over 25-30% of the nutrient, because if you do that, it also affects the yield. Once we finish the fertilizer application, the important one too is weed control.
Okay.
So once our subscribers have started sowing the maize, and now they need the fertilizer, as soon as they get a fertilizer application, then we have to also talk about the weed control.
Mm.
So that after the weed control, then we go to the armyworm infestation. That meaning that the whole year we are finished with the maize.
Sort
the everyone who is willing to be a maize farmer. So if you need anything 24/7, you call me. Maybe I'm in my farm. You can send an audio or message. When I get to you, I'll reply for you. Thank you very much. Now, someone asked some question about coconut farming.
Okay.
And I want to seek your permission.
Mm.
Once we are now in a fertilizer application, let's take some time and address coconut.
So
because
we also have Mr. Charles, who is also taking a video on
cabbage farming. Okay.
So
then
we are going to talk about
the coconut and the cabbage.
And the cabbage.
Before we, by the time we come, we will start the weed control.
Okay. So in our next video, I'm going to talk about coconut farming.
Yes.
Also, look out for a video on the cabbage farming. If you are planning
the intensive video this time, let me add the word intensive, because the one from scratch.
Yes.
Because we've done the cabbage already, but the subscriber need the intensive video on
mean,
the step by step approach.
Okay.
Of the cabbage. That is why I want to go back, because that one too is a very lucrative business.
We are approaching the planting season for coconut, and so in the next video we are going to talk about coconut farming as requested by one of our subscribers, and we also talk about cabbage farming in the next video. So if you don't want to miss any of these videos, make sure you stay tuned to this channel so you can be able to explore all these opportunities and then be able to make an informed decision. See you in the next video. Bye bye.